Better late than never. Okay. St. John's on that side. The cloth on this side. It's the opening match of the season. And the cloth is up 2-1. What am I doing here? Oh, killer serve. And the early odds on this match were cloth in a sweep. 3-0. That's what I'm expecting. Cloth up 3-2. By the way, today's date is September 5th, 2017. I think the cloth girl's been back in school for a while, and they've been training volleyball. Well, that's a year-round. That's way, way out. 4-2 cloth. And yes, I will make an appearance every now and then to catch a game, as long as I'm not busy doing something else. This past weekend, out by a mile. I was up in Maine, watching Kristen and her University of New England team in her senior year. And actually is going to go up to New York this weekend to watch her again in a tournament. But we got a couple funerals to attend here at the end of the week, so that's not going to work, unfortunately. Also had planned on going to see Jessica. She's in a tournament in West Palm Beach this weekend, but guess what? Out. Ooh, that was out. Been on the phone finding when she's going to get evacuated from her college because of a hurricane coming into town. Oh, good up. Kill it now. That's the update for your camera guy. Now back to the volleyball. Ooh, is that number two a setter down there? Nah, she's an outside hitter. Disguised as a libero. We all know that. 5-4. Up by one. St. John's is making this one interesting. Pretty loud for a season opener here at the cloth. Then again, the cloth venue will take the gift, is always loud. I met Terrence's sister-in-law yesterday, I believe. Boy, she told me some stories. Oh, boy, did she tell me some stories. And a gift. Funny thing, Jessica was been down in Florida for about 5-6 weeks now with her team, and we went down for orientation a couple weeks ago, and we're snaking through the orientation lines, long lines. They got really nice facilities down there, and about 5 or 6 girls walked by, all over 6'3". I mean, they were giants. And I figure that's got to be the basketball team coming into their locker room. And as they walk by our line, which is very crowded, they all look down. Hi, Jess. Hi, Jess. Hi, Jess. Hey, Jess. And I'm like, don't tell me they're your volleyball team? And they said, yep. So she's among giants down there. Amazing when you go up a level. Killers. Hey, your Tartans are up 10-7 right now. Nicole's serving. Some things never change, do they? Just gets up, calm and under control. 11-9. Tell you what, St. John's has a lot of spirit over there, girls. Come on. Our cloth bench needs to pick it up over there. Here we go. Cloth up, 11-9. Gift of the day, 12-10. In tight games like this, the gifts will kill you every time. Third gift by St. John's. That is going to kill them. How'd that volleyball taste over there? Right back in your face. Well, it would have been better, a little salt and pepper on it maybe, but geez. Wow. Right in your face. Nice. Cloth up, 15-12. Kept it alive. 15-13. All right, Cloth, let's get up five now. Come on. First 5-point lead of the afternoon. Let's go. And finish them off. Here we go. give Terrence. He's got a bad angle there. I've got a good angle. Plus, he's not an official. Dave gave the ref the evil eye over there, and he changed his call, gave us the homer call. Of course, I don't know what's going on, but I saw the eagle glare, the evil glare going over there, and he got scared and changed the call. Hopefully, it was the correct call. I have no idea, but it's 18-15 cloth. St. John's didn't miss three serves. They'd really been this one out. Ooh, good thing they touched it. 19-16. Give it to me. 20-16. And so starts the final countdown. I missed the first point, but there's an ace, and it's 2-0.
That's S.
Hello.
No G.
Hello. I don't know if I can yell that or not. Hey, until it stops. Yeah, just keeps hammering it. Keep going to the well, Nicole. Yep. No, they got that one up, though. Good eye, St. John, 4-1. Thank you. two on the gift. Number one of set number two, first gift. That's going to be their downfall today. Jade has found her target to pick on. Let's see if it goes again. 6-2. Two more points and St. John's will be calling timeout. Sisterly love right there. Give her another one. Give her another up. Going over to. Yep.
One Riley.
In ping pong, that's a let. Or it used to be a let, at least when I was a kid under ping pong rules. 8-6, clock. Now, yelling S, like, just is not the same as yelling G. Yay, G. I don't know. Yes. Now, it doesn't sound the same. You're going to have to come up with a different call. Sasha. I mean, I love the, yeah, G! But, I'm going to have to ponder that and hopefully by the end of the season I can come up with something. 9-6 cloth. Second gift, just when a chance, when St. John's has the opportunity to tie it up. 10-8 on the gift. Hey, see, we got a new sign up in the cloth place up there. I love it. Holy Cross Volleyball. Nice. 11-8 cloth. That was donated by the Geyser Endowment, I believe, last year. And we give them a gift, 11-9. Yeah, when Dave retired from the government, you know how it is. Got that nice, huge government pension. And he endowed a chair here at the school, and with some of it, he bought the Holy Cross volleyball sign. And I guess he hasn't told you yet, so I'll tell you now. He's planning at the end of the season a dinner for all the parents of the Cross in the last several years, just to thank them for their support for the team. We're all going to be going out to dinner, and it's going to be at Ruth Chris in Bethesda. All on Dave. Oh, I guess I wasn't supposed to tell you that. Oh, well, I'm sure Coach Dave will be sending an email to that effect towards the end of the season, but we got to get the six-peat first. It's 12-9 Cloth. Out by a mile. 12-10. I'm sorry, I can't even count. I'm losing my mind. 13-9. Team 10 Cloth. Well placed, well placed. 14-10. Back at you, St. John's. Ha ha. Back at you, St. John's. Ha ha. Ha ha. Cloth got a 5-point lead now. 15-10. Don't stop, ladies. I want 10. I want 10.
6-6-6.
And we get some coaching from the sidelines here to number 6 spot. And you see what happens. Do I do that? Or do I do what Dave said? Oh, Dad says it's a shank. Uh-oh. But Dad can say that, I guess. I won't say that. 16-11. Cloth still up by 5.
Go, Jay.
Big lead. Big lead, ladies. Here we go. Ouch, that had a hurt. I mean, that thing would break your fingers. I've been on the receiving end a few of those, screwing around in the backyard with my daughters, and it's like you do it once, like, I'm not playing volleyball anymore. I like my fingers. I like them to be intact. Well, Jay found their weak spot. Keep hitting it. Timeout. Cloth. What am I saying? Timeout, St. John's. 18-11. I'm going to show you. We were down in Florida last week. Got a picture of Jessica's team. Now, looking at this, without looking at faces, can you pick out which one is Jessica on this team? Can you pick her out yet? Where is she? I wonder, is she that one? I don't know. Where is Jessica, and how do you tell? How can you tell? Oh, getting in a little too close. I know you know which one Jessica is. Anyway, let's get back to the game. Timeout. Coming out of the timeout. Cloth up 18-11. Wow. Well, you might as well abuse the spot while you can. Until their serve receives, you can get it back up. Do it again, Jay. 19-11. Here we go. Gives him again. 19-12. Here we go. Thank you. So starts the final countdown. 20 to 13, Cloth. 20 to 14. Now, I've been having trouble with my editing software this week, so these will not be up to my usual standard. So forgive me in advance, ladies. Gets a nut every now and then, right? So, let's finish them off. Come on. There we go. Oh, they got it up. Good for them. Now finish it. Thank you. Big big mistake on my part. I missed the first set. I thought the game was at 6. So the cloth, hey, my prediction was correct anyway. I said the cloth would sweep, and the cloth did sweep. Sorry about that, ladies, missing the first set. Oh, well, looks good. Let's get that 6-peat.
And that's all, folks.